Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum and very good morning to all of you. Dear students, I pray to Allah by the will and help of Almighty Allah. I hope each and every one of you is safe and sound at your homes. Remember, boys, to keep your hands and face clean. Wash them properly many times a day and use sterilizer for yourselves. And be careful, do not go out. Today we are going to continue our lesson number 25, which is on page number 72 and 73. I would like to continue from where we have left. Now, boys, in this lesson we are talking about the Jamaat congregation, how we recite our Salah in masajids. But nowadays you all know that it's lockdown and we have to pray at home. But still at home, our fathers, our brothers, our mothers, sisters, they all can pray in Jamaat. Now, merits of Salah in congregation, yani the rewards that Allah has told us, Allah has informed us about it, and how much it benefits us when we pray the Salah in congregation, in Jamaat. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam has reported to have said that the one who offers Salah perfectly with Jama for 40 days without missing the first takbir. Do you understand? Yani for 40 days without, he went to the masjid or at home or wherever, if they are in a congregation, but the condition is in congregation, in Jamaat. Whoever has performed Salah for 40 days, two things are going to happen. Number one, he will be free from hellfire. And number two, hypocrisy. Well, hypocrisy, as we all know about it, the munafiqat, you know. So, in people, and munafiqeen has very, 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 lower level in nar, in jahannam. For munafiqeen, they are worse than kuffar. Okay, so we have to be very careful and seek Allah's forgiveness about it. And secondly, to offer Salah with Jamaat is 27 times more rewarding, boys. Subhanallah, look at this, how benefit Allah gives us if we pray Salah in congregation. Yani any Salah, if we are praying it alone, we are going to get the reward of it. Okay, but for congregation, for Jamaat, we are going to get 27 more times. Subhanallah, this is the reward that Allah has promised us. And he who offers the Isha in congregation, in Jamaat, yani Isha, Salah Isha, it is if he has prayed the whole night. And this is Sahih Muslim's hadith. It is an authentic hadith. So, subhanallah, look at the benefit of it. Now, Salah offering in Jamaat is 27 times more valuable as compared to his offering alone at home. So, and another thing I would like to add this upon another Sahih Muslim's hadith. It says that for when a person performs wudu, doing it well, you know, and goes out to the mosque, for every step, yani if he is in love with the Salah and in love with the, you know, for Allah, the step, every step he is going to take forward, he is being raised a degree and having a sin forgiven about it. Subhanallah, look at the sawab, look at the rewards that Allah has promised us for this. So this is very important, guys. We have to be we try our level best, but nowadays we have this problem because of this virus that we are facing. But still, we can offer Salah at homes with our family. So, you or your fathers, tell them to lead the Salah, and you carry on in congregation as you can all, as we do it in Jamaat. Now, Some important features of Jamaat is the Imam, as we all know, the leader who leads the Salah, stands in front in the middle of the Masjid, and everybody the followers stand behind him in ranks, in saf, in lines, you know. And then they start the Salah with saying Allahu Akbar, and we all have to repeat it softly and join the prayer. Then Imam will recite Surah Al-Fatiha from the passage, and the passage from the holy book. Then we go for Ruku, right? And there is two types of Salat in Fajr, Maghrib and Isha. We say it Jirri. Jirri means that we say Quran out loud. And in Dhuhr and in Asr, we are silent. We do not say it out loud. Understood? Then, at the end of a Surah Al-Fatiha, an Imam would say Ameen, which means Allah grant our prayer. You should also say Ameen. It's about fiqh. Some people say it out loud, some people say it in their hearts or with their lips or softly. It's up to you. But we have to say Ameen, whether, wherever, however we like it, right? Then Imam is appointed to follow when he recites Takbir. You also said recite Takbir when he prostrates for Ruku and prostrate for Sujood. And in Ruku, we say Subhana Rabbi Al Azim. We praise Allah. Do not remember one thing, boys, in congregation, do not advance from the Imam. As Imam says Allahu Akbar, then only change your condition. If you're standing up, if he wants to go for a ruku, do not hesitate in it. Do not do anything before Imam. It's a must. Otherwise, you will be held accountable for. Okay? So, be careful in it. Whenever you hear Imam saying Allahu Akbar, then change your position. And especially in sujood as well, do not move before Imam saying Allahu Akbar. Do not change your position before Imam saying Allahu Akbar. Is that clear? So everything we should follow. And you know, one more thing, after Surah Fatiha, at the end of Surah Fatiha, when Imam says Ghayril Maghdubi Alayhim Waladdallin, and he says Ameen, and if our voices join with Imam in saying Ameen, whether we are saying out loud or in our hearts or softly, the angels also say Ameen. If our, you know, synchronize with angels, Ameen, and with the Imam, right? If it synchronize, then Allah is going to forgive our all sins. Subhanallah. This is also the miracle. This is also the reward, the best reward of saying Salah in congregation. Well, there are other things as well, but we have to continue for the next session. Hope you all will do good in at homes, and please, it's only masajids which are closed for Salah, not our homes. And there is no, you know, point that we are free from a Salah. Boys, 5 times a day, every day. Okay, do not forget to offer Salah. Is that clear? May Allah protect us all. Ma salama, take care of everybody. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.